attention because I'm not at my usual place. Here we have a big box marked
Fragile.
And what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be repairing an iPad. So this is my first iOS device. Let's fix it. I have fixed iPhones, I think, and stuff like that before, but not as, I haven't done any iPads, but I haven't actually recorded any of my iOS. That's just a filler piece right here. Well, you can't see anything, obviously, because the box isn't there. It's one of these just cardboard fillers. Inside this really cool bag, I like this bag. Let's get into the box here. This is a bag, and it's got, well, obviously it's a bag, and it's got the screen inside, which is what we'll be replacing today on this iPad. So, without further ado, this iPad belonged to my aunt and uncle, and whilst they were on holiday, my youngest cousin, I think, or sister, not sure, sister-in-law maybe, not sure, threw this iPad down and smashed it, and basically, there was panic, well, like you would, you've just dropped your expensive, well, not really expensive, this is a third-gen iPad right here, nothing too fancy, there was a bit of panic, and my grandfather purchased a new front glass, because, you know, you don't want your child cutting your fingers. Unfortunately, she threw it down so hard that it's actually cracked the LCD under the glass as well. It destroyed the glass as well, but we got rid of the glass, it's fine. So, the first problem was on this that there was no touch, and what had happened is my grandfather had installed the screen, somehow installed the screen, miraculously. That was actually really good. I think he followed iFixit, I think. He didn't just wing it, which is actually really cool. I like that, because people are actually starting to fix things themselves. He just basically just plugged it in whilst the thing was not turned off. Like, in order to install something on any computer, you can't just, like, you know, pop a graphics card in or pop some RAM in or your computer's on, you've got to turn it off and unplug it before it will work. So basically what he did with this is similar. So this is basically, it's now been wiped. It was working before, but this is basically now wiped, un-iCloud locked. It's had the account removed. So what we're going to do is, if I get my iOS toolkit right here, it's not the fanciest thing in the world. I don't have any iFixit stuff yet. I will be getting myself some iFixit tools, hopefully in the near future. So what we're going to do is we are going to remove the old LCD panel, crap now, it's damaged, we don't need it anymore. So let's get our guitar pick, which is the thinnest piece of plastic I've ever handled in my life, and this could just snap off at any given time, but what we're going to do is we're just going to ease around the LCD with this, cutting out the adhesive. I could just run my fingers across it as well. The adhesive holding this display on is incredibly weak, and it's very, very bad. I can't remember where I left the glue for this as well. I swear I left the glue somewhere. So basically, what I'm going to do is remove the glass. And I'm going to time-lapse this, actually. I'm going to test my skills of editing with time-lapse. So I'm going to time-lapse taking this off, and then I'll get back to you. Okay, I think we've got it. So, I think with iPads, you've got to be very careful. So down here is the ribbon cable for the touch digitizer, the LCD. This is the glass piece. Now this glass piece is good. It's not dodgy, it's not broken, so we're going to be very careful with it. So now we're just going to remove the four screws holding the LCD in place. Did I turn the iPad off before I started? Yes, I did. Remember, always turn the iPad off before doing anything. This lowers your chance of damaging things. Now, for some weird reason, my hay fever's come back and I've started recording, so that's a positive. So if there's any sniffles in here, it's coming from me. But I can still talk normally, so it's okay, you won't lose me. So those are the four screws, you won't be able to see them, but there we go, you can lower the camera there, you can see them. I'm using my old ThinkPad, because the webcam in my new ThinkPad doesn't actually work. I will probably get around to fixing another episode of Let's Fix It, stay tuned for that. But what we're going to do now is we're just going to gently take the LCD out, be very careful. Fold it in the same direction the digitizer's in. That way you won't tear any cables. If you fold it like the other way, like out this direction, you will break something. So yeah, just keep that in mind. So now we just gotta lift up this little plastic latch. I'll do this with my fingers. There we go. And then just gently unplug it. So there is our LCD. We can be as rough as we want with this now, because it's broken, it's damaged, we don't care about it, so I'm just going to eat it on the floor. So here is our new LCD assembly. What should I do? Because the casing is a little bit kinked. I'm not sure. I don't think it really matters, to be fair. It's not like for a customer or anything. It's not like they're going to care, it's just for my grandfather who wants a slight upgrade from his aging Galaxy Tab 4. So it says iPad 4 on the back for some odd reason, but this is a grade C, meaning it's, well, grade C usually means that it's good, like it works, but it's, you know, not in the best of condition, which I'm alright with. Yeah, it's a little bit dirty. It's a little bit dirty, but this'll work. It's the same layout. It's an OEM part, it's been ripped out of a broken iCloud locked iPad, so here's the old screen and here's the new one. Side by side, you can see they're pretty much similar in terms of design, the cables, the hookup, everything's the same. There's like no differences between the iPad 4 and the iPad 3, I believe, aside from the charging port, which went from the dock connector to the lightning connector that they use nowadays. I can't confirm that. If anyone can confirm that, leave it in the comments. So with inserting it, you want to make sure that the white line is either completely disappeared or barely visible. If you see any like white line on the wire, it's not inserted fully enough. Now, be careful when layering the display back down, because, you know, you've got to fight with the digitizer cable as well, and the digitizer doesn't like, you know, being handled roughly, so we're just going to layer it back a little bit so we don't tear the cable. I'm going to grab our Phillips head screwdriver. It's quite cheap, but it is magnetized. Probably shouldn't say that ever. There's someone who hates magnetized screwdrivers because it makes them think of a Star Wars quote or something. I don't know who it was, but I should probably refrain from saying magnetized in case they're watching. So here is the. So we're going to put the new panel back in now. I really should script these things, but if I script them, they're gonna feel like they're staged. And I don't want that. This is a genuine repair. This is just me. I've been sent something by a family member and they would like me to repair it. That's all. So, yeah. So, now we've installed the screws. We're going to take a break because we're going to clean the inside of this out. We're going to get rid of all the stickiness on the screen, and I'm going to stop here to try and locate all the things I need and get rid of the rubbish. So I'll be right back. So now I'm going to basically use my toothbrush here. Well, not my toothbrush. This is a cleaning brush. I'm not going to use this for dental hygiene. We're going to use this. Be very careful with isopropyl alcohol. This is an electrical device. There's electricity going through it. And one stray spark and you've set it on fire. So be careful. This is pure isopropyl alcohol as well. So this stuff will flame up. Does isopropyl alcohol actually catch fire? Or is that lighter fluid I'm thinking of? I think, yeah, alcohol can burn. But I think it does depend on the purity. So what else we're going to do is we're going to pour in a little bit of isopropyl. We're not going to pour much, we're just going to pour a drop into the lid. Like that. And then we're going to pour it onto here, onto this here cloth. I did have a microfiber pneumatic Henry novelty gift thing, which was good for cleaning screens, but I lost it, unfortunately. It is in this bedroom somewhere. I remembered where I last saw it, but unfortunately I couldn't find it in time for filming, so we're going to have to make do with what we got and clean all the fingerprints off of the screen manually. Because everybody knows that an unclean screen looks awful when you reassemble it. Now this one still has some streaks on it, so I'm going to just go over it directly down. Down, swift strokes down the screen, just get rid of all the impurities and make sure that the screen, it looks good for when the user wishes to use it. So if I can find where I left the double-sided tape, we're going to apply some with precision. Found it. So here's our double-sided tape, and we're going to apply some around the screen. We're going to cut it to size as well. If I can find my scissors. Can't find my scissors. Okay. Found my scissors. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to cut not too big, but a little strip of double-sided tape. So this we're also going to cut to size. So I'm going to recommend people don't waste this stuff, because it is kind of a waste, if you know what I mean. So what we're going to do is we're going to apply a little bit here, a layer down the side, and then we're going to fold it back and cut it to size. Oops. Yeah, this is going to be a bit messy. Unless I could just, stick it to the back of the screen. That probably might actually help, to be fair. Yeah, I'm gonna stick this all to the screen. And I'll get back, because I'm not going to waste my time time-lapsing this. So, I tried to apply the double-sided tape, but it wasn't really working out for me. So what we're going to do is we're just going to gently lay the iPad LCD back down, or the digitizer back down. Oops, I was pointing at it at that time. Another good thing to do is to test things, test that things work. Like so, look, we're getting an Apple logo, and we have no lines on the screen. A positive start. Now we just want to make sure we haven't actually damaged the ribbon cable. Yeah, these adhesive strips didn't really work out right. I thought these were supposed to be double-sided tape, but whatever they weren't working. But I think it did make, like, the insides a bit stickier trying to remove them. So maybe they're like wax patches, but they apply sticky stuff when you remove them. So once that's booting up, we're going to apply a little bit more isopropyl alcohol, being careful where we pour it, because we don't want to set anything on fire. Just on the screen. Shit. We don't want to, you know, spin anything. Just going over the screen like so. I mean, I could just use glasses. You know, the little fabric thing you get inside glasses, cases, and stuff like that. I don't have any of those, sadly. Just gonna clear the screen, and there we go. You can see that the iPad is actually alive, the touch is working, and we can set it up. I don't know if he wants us to set it up, but I'll set it up off camera, you know, data protection and all. So thank you all for watching. This has been another episode of Let's Fix. Well, not really yet, so I haven't finished putting the screen down. This has been an episode of Let's Fix It. We hope you enjoyed, and catch you in the next one. See ya!